So, in the previous tutorials, we had the GTI with the William Optics 61 in Alt AS mode. In the Alt mode, as we describe it, you have two motions basically. You have the azimuth and you have the altitude. Now we would like to convert it to equatorial mount. And to do that, you have to add a few peripherals. The advantage of equatorial mount is that you follow the rotation of the Earth and therefore it's very, very accurate. It's rotated with the Earth movement around the node and therefore it's more accurate. However, it requires more complicated alignment. You have to align with the north pole. So first, I'll convert the hardware to equatorial mode. For that, I'll take the telescope out. And I'll present the necessary components. First, we need the wedge. And the wedge is the one that will create the latitude in your location. Every location has different latitude. So in the equator, it's 0 degrees. At the zenith, which is vertical, it's 90 degrees. And here in Costa de Casa, it's 33 degrees. So I can actually change here to any degrees, depends where I am. So I open it and I move it and I'll put it in 33 degrees and lock it. That's not very accurate, but after you do the alignment, it will adjust. So in order to put this edge, we have to remove a few components and install a few components. So I'll remove the GTI from the tripod. And first I have to remove the attachment here. So don't try to remove it from here. Move it with the screw here. So now you have the mount and the adapter to the mount. But now instead of going to the mount, I will install the wedge. Tied it pretty hard, so when it moved in the azimuth direction, it will not slip here. And then I'll put it in, lock the bolt, and now I have the angle here. And in order to put the telescope on it, the William Optics, I need to first put the mount. And in order to put the mount, there are many ways to attach it with dovetail connections, but here is one adapter. So I just tie it up. Also, you have to tie it pretty hard. In this case, I just will do it with my fingers here, because for demonstration, then I'll tie it up. And I'll fit it in. The screws, make sure they're tied. Still make sure that it's 33 degrees, which it is. Later on we can adjust it. And now it's time to put the telescope. And this is very important. It took me a long time and it's not in the documentation. Where the telescope should be, where it should be pointing out. What is the zero-zero position? Well, I know it's 33 degrees, it depends on the location here for the... where it is as far as the azimuth connected. I will move the altitude and now I'll insert. To drop it. As far as you can, so it's balanced. This is not balanced yet, so. Okay, this is balanced better. Now one thing which is very important, that the zero-zero position when you start has to be exactly 33 degrees here. Make sure it doesn't slip out. And lock it. Now you see how it's in balance, it's falling down. So I will tie it up. The screw here, but that's not good enough. You have to counter it with weight. And for that, I have 1 kilogram weight attached to a bar here. Make sure that this screw is holding it or you're going to break your toes. And you have to insert it in. Sometimes it's better to insert it before, but I'll insert it now. It happened many times that you forget to put the screw in the end and the weight slide out and you have a problem with your toes for a while. So all the way. Okay, it's all the way, lock it, make sure the screw is there. So that's how it looks from the side. Now, when I open, the azimuth motion, it's still not balanced, and the reason it's not balanced is because this is not all the way up, so I'm not all the way up. Let's see how it is now. That's better. I'll open it more here just to make sure. That's good. It's not 100%, maybe you need more weight there, but that's good enough because it's very seldom will go all the way down. So that's pretty good. Without the weight, it will fall down. Now lock it up. So this is the position that the telescope should be converted into equatorial mode. And after that, we have to align it with the North Pole, which is very difficult. There is no scope here. And there is no eyepiece. You can put an eyepiece, but it's not very accurate. So I got something which is relatively expensive, but it's called Polar Master. I'll bring the Polar Master. Demonstrate tonight. The Polar Master will find precisely where is the North Pole. This is amazing. So this is how the telescope with its mount, AZGTI, set up, pointing to the North. Now to find the North, it's some problems, because you need the scope, and I don't have the scope here. This one set with the eyepiece and a diagonal. So you have to try to find it with your eyes. And 80 years old eyes are not as good as 25 years old eyes. So I purchased what's called Paul Masters. And the Paul Master, which made by QHYCCD, automatically using the notebook or the table, whatever it is, tablets, it will find it. And there is procedure which I'll go in the future for that. So you set it up here. Tie it up. And now it's the same angle with the OTA, with the tube. You plug it to the notebook. And you have a whole apps that will tell you what to do, which will go with that in the future. Now there are some more pieces that are important here. Right now I'm using an eyepiece and a diagonal. But how are you going to store the images? So it's either using digital cameras, which will do that too, or DSLR camera. Nikon, for example, or Canon. Now to do that, you need special attachment. And for the William Optics 61, you got to have a flatter. It's called the William Optics Flat 61. And it's quite a tricky to connect it, so I'll show it to you. First of all, you need a special eyepiece. This eyepiece is from William Optics. Normal T-rings will not fit. You have to have one that will fit into the flat 61. Now that will connect to the camera. And I'll show how it connects to the camera. Connect to the camera, here I have the Nikon D850, which is a great camera. I'll remove the regular lens that came with that. And I'll connect with the T-rings. So I'll take the T-rings off here. You don't have to take it off, but just to show it. It's going to the Nikon. Each camera has its own T-ring, so it's connected. And now I can connect the Flex 61 to it. You have other parts here that make the connector longer or shorter. It depends on the focusing. So you have to focus, and if it doesn't focus right, you remove it and take one of the sleeve out. And now you are closer to the sensor. So now it's shorter. So it depends on the focus to find out the best combination. In my combination, I had to put an extension. So this is the extension. And then put the T-rings on the extension, tied it up, and here I have it. Now to connect it to the telescope, it's tricky. Maybe people, it's not in the menu. So first I have to remove the diagonal here with the eyepiece. So it's off. And now you want to connect the flat, the optic flat 61. No way to connect it. And you say, oh, I got the wrong piece. So you buy another piece. So it's $100. So another $100 went to the wastebasket. And then you find out from Trevor Jones that I wish I could meet someday. And you have to remove this ring here. Can you believe that? You have to move the ring. And now the flat 61 will screw right into it. And the camera will connect now to the T-Rex. So now I can see if I can focus it. I just will aim it to the outside with the little planks there. Try to focus it. Yeah. Focus very well. If I go forward, you see, focus it, and I can actually collect data using the DSLR. So after we set the cameras, the telescope, we set it up to the north. This is an equatorial mode. So in order to set it there, you open the clutch here, and the way it used to be, it was in this position, but now we have the wedge, so we set it almost 33 degrees, like the latitude. Close the wedge, make sure the telescope, the William Optic 61, point to the north, and in order to know if it's pointing to the north, of course it's a day simulation. At night you cannot see, so I do it in the day simulation. So I look to find the polar star. So let's find where it's Polaris. Here's Polaris. So I go in and try to align it with the telescope. And that's not bad. That's not bad. So of course it's just a simulation in the daylight. So now assuming it's in the north, We are going to try to do alignment in the daylight. So I'll start the telescope, the mount. I'll go to the Wi-Fi connection, Wi-Fi, find the Syscan EE58, click on it, it will connect, did connect, and now I go to the telescope, which is the Syscan Pro, connected, and it's equatorial mode, not alt-az, it's equatorial mode. It's a warning, avoid injury for the sun, just to make sure that it's connected. Yeah, I could hear it. So the first thing to do is alignment. Of course, I don't have stars now outside. So I go alignment and I'll select one star alignment. So I select one star alignment. And it asks me for Venus, Sirius, Mercury. I'll go to Sirius. And I said begin alignment. And based on the fact that I was pointing north, it would find the Sirius. And that's a daylight, I don't see the star, of course. So it seems approximately right. Well, you think that here is Sirius. Let's see if I go to the application Skyview and search for Sirius. Search in the stars.
and Sirius defines S. I found it.
Sirius, let's see where it is. Here it is. And it's in the direction. It's probably not exactly because I'm doing it in the daylight with an app. But it's pretty good. So I'll get out. And now
I go back to the application. To see scan
Paul.
I'm there.
And it tells you to manually center, so if it's not exactly manually, but I don't see it, so I'll pretend. And it says alignment successful. So now let's see if it will find the Polaris, for example. So I'll go back and I say star. And name star, and I'll say Polaris.
Polaris. Found it.
I say go to. Well, let's check how good it is. It's still lying here. Go to the sky view. See where it's Polaris. Here it is. It's so bad. So even with no stars, I can find many stars. Well, that's happened to me all the time. So, I'll go out, and basically, we did align the equatorial mode in the GTI with the William Optics 61. And tonight, I'll take it outside and try to do it with the real stars.